you've heard that over and over and over and over again. But I can honestly tell you, don't make the mistakes that we did. Don't choose the choices that we chose when we didn't have God a part of our life. Come on, isn't that the truth? Because it is nothing more than heartache, and it'll break up, and it will destroy your home. And that's exactly what the devil would want you to do. And it's important that we always try to align ourselves with His will. When we do, heaven aligns itself with us. We align ourselves with heaven. Earth has to line itself up as well. And I can honestly tell you that Solomon, in all his knowledge, came to realize at the end that the only thing that can truly fulfill him is God. So, this morning, what are you going to choose? There are many of us that are pursuing things that we know in our heart of hearts that is doing nothing more than breaking up our marriage and breaking up our homes. And it is putting your career at jeopardy simply because of the fact that you're chasing things that you know that you shouldn't chase. Your family is hurting because you're choosing to be selfish. Am I talking to somebody here this morning? Because of your choices, you're hurting those that love you most. And you're pushing away the people who really do care about you. Solomon, in this case, did the exact thing. I can honestly tell you, Solomon's first wife was, I can imagine the joy that she had in knowing that she was going to be the king's wife. And for a season, she felt like she was his everything. But it wasn't enough for him that he had to go out and he had to find other women. How do you think that made her feel? Oh, good. There's other women that can share the responsibility. Come on. Help me out.
Worthless.
Not good enough. Felt ugly inside. Maybe there's a woman here today that you kind of feel like you're unworthy because your spouse or your mate has not given you the attention and the affection and the communication that you've been wanting. And it's simply because, as a mate, we've been selfish. Ouch or amen. You know, and the bottom line is also, for us as men, we too can feel alone. We too can feel that we are in need. Can I tell you one of the top five things that men need, other than sexual intimacy, is being number one? Is number two, having a partner that's willing to go out and do an outside activity with. And many of the women are like, I don't want to go out there with you. It's too hot. You know I'm not that type of girl. When you married me, you know I was in an outdoors world. So us guys, what do? We go out and we hang out with other guys. And we're completely doing opposite things from each other. And what happens is the devil has made his way in and continues to bring separation in the household. As parents, we have responsibilities to our children that we are not fulfilling. We are not teaching them what we need to teach them, the biblical principles and about character growth. Because we need to understand that God is more interested in our than He is in our. And the bottom line is that we need to focus in on what we need to do. We need to really be pursuing not those things that are selfish, but rather that's going to bring unity and peace and hope and joy into our household. It may be things that are not popular, but they are the right things that we need to do. Maybe you need to stop for a season going out and being on a softball team and spend more time with your children at home. Maybe that will make the biggest difference in your children changing their attitude and wanting to bring more respect to you or having more respect to you as parents. It's about home because, believe it or not, our children grow up very, very fast. And before you know it, they're getting ready to go out the door. The biggest worry that I have is that I have not taught my children everything that I needed to have taught them in the Word to prepare them and to get them ready so that when they go out and face the situations at life, because I know that they will have the ability and the knowledge and the understanding to say no to the things they need to say no to and yes to the things they need to say yes to. That is one of the biggest concerns I have as a parent. So how much time and effort am I putting in and spending quality time with my children to teach them these things? Or am I busy just being too busy? Pushing them aside and hoping that someone else, maybe at church, or maybe another friend, or maybe somewhere out there, they'll learn it the way I had to learn it. Hard knocks. And I can honestly tell you, that is what got me into more trouble than anything else. And you have regrets. So let me ask you today, if you're a parent, an uncle, an aunt, or a grandparent, how much time is going in the effort and teaching and building and helping your household be the foundation and the stability that your children need so that they're ready to walk into life prepared? So what do you need to do? You need to stop chasing things that are selfish and pursue after things that are going to help build your household that are in line with God's will for your life. And maybe this morning, that's why you're here. Maybe because you're tired of pursuing those things and you're saying, you know what, I really want to begin to pursue what is righteous, what is true, that's going to help me overall. There are a lot of us that are making up for those missed times and opportunities. We're looking back and saying, where did time go? Time was gone because we weren't spending it where we needed to. Have you ever thought maybe the reason why God closes doors in our lives is so that He would force us to be able to be responsible in the areas that we need to be responsible in our households?
Amen.
Maybe He's closed the door at your work, or from you not going to school this particular semester because He is trying to capture or get your attention and letting you know if you don't spend the time there, the devil will. And we need to begin to do that. It's important that we do that with our dear loved ones. It's time that we stop pursuing these things. It is too dangerous. Because we're the gatekeepers of our houses, that we need to begin to watch over and do what God has called us to do.
Amen.
If you agree to that, and you know in your hearts that that is what you want to do, I'm going to ask that you would just stand and come forward to this altar without any hesitation. As a gatekeeper in your house, as an adult in your house, and you're saying, you know what, I really need to do this. I really allow time just to go, just kind of go by and not do what I needed to get done. As you're doing this, I can honestly tell you, you are beginning to just be vulnerable to God, and God's already begun to stand in your corner and is already beginning to say, I'm with you, I forgive you, I'm going to help you be the man and the woman that you're wanting to be.